Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. At this episode, I want to address a little bit about auto. Now, I've given two episodes on auto recently, and I get a fair bit of pushback whenever I mention auto on Twitter. I get less pushback, I think, in the comments on this channel, but on Twitter, a lot of people have a problem with auto. So I just wanted to do what I think will be, again, a relatively quick episode. I know I say that, doesn't always end up being a quick episode, on constraining auto. Now, the main problem that people have with auto is that auto can be anything. If I've got some function that I'm calling here, and I don't have some function defined, let's go ahead and give it a quick definition. Then I'm probably still going to get a compile error here, but I have no idea what the type of P is going to be here. So I've got this use of auto before deduction of auto. So I'm trying to deduce both of these at once. It doesn't have any way of doing that. That's a fair error from the compiler. This isn't really the end of the story, though, because in C++ 20 with concepts, we can constrain auto. So let's go ahead and do a couple of things here. I'm going to return 1 from this function. Now, it's going to deduce that the return type of this function is an int, and therefore p on line 14 should become an int, although I have warnings treated as errors here. So P is an int. Now reading this code, we don't necessarily know that, but we can put some constraints on here. So I actually can say that this is a function that is returning an integral. And this is the way that it looks in C++ 20 with the terse syntax for concept constraints. So I can say, this is an auto, it is constrained to be an integer. If I try to return a double from this function, then I'm going to get a compile time error on line 9. Likewise, if I were to come down here and say that this is a floating point value that I'm expecting from some function, then I'm going to get a compile time error again. So this can be any kind of floating point number or any kind of integral. So if I take this back and I say this is going to return a floating point, I can even go so far as to say, and I know that I covered this somewhat in my intro to concepts C++ 20 episode, but now I can take any two floating point types. Now this is at the moment going to require both of these to be floating point types, but it doesn't care what type of floating point type. So I can pass it a float and a double. Now I'm going to get a dash W conversion error here. Let's see, on the return from main. So at this point, what is P? Is P a float? Is it a double? Is it a long double? I don't know. But I do know that it is a floating point number, and for many cases, that is usually fine. Now, one of the problems that people had in my previous episode was pointers. I'll name this confusingly. And I want to make a couple of points here as well. In this function, ob, let's go ahead and name this obj, is a pointer. On line 17, that is a pointer. But by a quick glance at this code, we don't necessarily know that. And that is partially a problem with naming, right? Because I'm saying that this function is a get function of some sort. Now, I would generally expect a getter to return a value or a reference, a little unexpected for it to return a pointer. Now, as we mentioned before, you can use the pattern matching rules and say, I do actually expect this to be a pointer. Now, if I change the signature of this function, I'm going to get a compile time error because OBJ can't possibly be a pointer. Now, one of the complaints that I saw was someone saying that they want to be able to maybe restrict their auto so that it is never a pointer, when we actually can do that as well. Now, it might get a little bit weird, but what we need to look at is this standard floating point and how it's implemented. So I'm in the concepts header for C++ 20 from CPP reference. And I can click on this floating point, and I can see here that this is an extraordinarily simply defined concept that is a template concept named floating point. And all it is equal to this is floating point V. I'm just going to steal that real quick. So I've got this, I'm defining my own floating point concept. I want to declare my own not pointer concept. And really this is to prove a point. This is the is pointer V. Now I am going to negate this. So this is just going to be a Boolean expression and we're not getting any compile errors there. Now we're still getting this compile error because that's not a pointer and get object is not a pointer. We know that. Okay. If I want to say this thing is definitely not a pointer, this should compile. There, it compiles no problem. And if I were to change this function signature again to actually return a pointer, now I should get a compile time error. Here we go. Error, deduced initializer does not satisfy placeholder constraints required for the satisfaction of not pointer, which is a not pointer V. So there we go. Using C++ 20 with concepts and constrained auto, we can get most of the things we want. We can guarantee anything that we want to about the type. We can't guarantee anything about the lifetime of the object or anything about the properties of the object, but we can certainly talk about its type in a compile time checked way. And as you saw here, we can constrain return types, parameter types, and object types using concepts in C++ 20 with auto. Now, this is all going to be important information for the next episode that I plan to record, which will air either immediately after this one or shortly after it within a couple of episodes. So make sure you stay tuned for that episode. And thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to give this a thumbs up, leave a comment, tell me what you thought about this, and be sure to subscribe.